What is this? Hello everybody, this is Hudson with Sanders Home Brewing and welcome back to the channel. Today we're doing something a little different. This right here is called honey powder. I've never heard of it before. I was walking around in the Korean market in downtown Los Angeles, and well, in Koreatown in Los Angeles, and I was roaming the aisles and, you know, thought that I would take a look at the honey aisle since I'd never looked at their honey aisle before, and I found this. There were several different brands. I ended up getting this one. It's 3 pounds of honey powder, which apparently on the back here says that it's used in tea, coffee, and honey tea as a replacement for table sugar. So it is sweet and it's made from honey. So what I'm imagining this is just kind of dried, crystallized honey that's just waiting to be rehydrated. It says there's 3 pounds of it here, so I don't know if that equates to 3 pounds of wet honey, or if it equates to more than 3 pounds of wet honey. So let's actually try that out. So I'm going to rehydrate some of it, and then I'm going to take a hydrometer reading and see just how many sugars we get from 1 quart of liquid. So to start off with, I really don't know what I'm doing with this. I haven't even tasted it. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna open it up, I'm gonna smell it, and I'm gonna taste it, and I'll talk about it. Ooh, you know what it looks like? It looks like oh, interesting. It smells like honey. Yeah, it smells like really dense honey. But it looks like yeast, you know, like a dry active yeast is what it looked like. So I'm just gonna take a little taste of it. Wow. Yeah, that tastes like honey. It just tastes like dried crystallized honey. That's really interesting how they get it like that. It doesn't look like sugar at all. It just looks like dry powder, but thick powder. So instead of doing it by volume, I'm going to do this by weight. So I'm a bartender. During the pandemic right now, I haven't really been able to practice any of my craft, but this is kind of how I make syrups. So basically what I'm going to be making today is like a honey syrup. So I'm going to be filling this up about halfway, and then we'll just kind of eyeball. Okay, right now we've got about, I'm gonna do 10 ounces of this, and then I'm gonna take some warm water, which I've heated up in my pot here, and then I'm gonna add, well, this is more like 11 ounces of the honey powder. I'm gonna add 11 ounces of regular water, should give us 22 ounces. Hold on, where is it? There it is, 22 ounces. And I'm gonna take the end that I didn't taste with, and I'm just gonna stir that up. And so far, it looks like it's dissolving. So I might add maybe another 10 ounces of the honey powder to this, and well, let's say 8 ounces of honey powder to this, and then we'll finish it off with, let me zero that out really quick, and then we will fill it up to just below the lip here so that we don't spill anything and it's not a spilling hazard. So that's zeroed out. We're going to go for 8 ounces of honey powder. Right up on the top there. Come on. So that will mean that we have added about 19 ounces. So a little over a pound of this we'll have added to this quart. Actually, that looks like it's going to be enough right there. So I'm going to stop at 6.7 ounces of the honey powder. And we're going to finish off 6 ounces of this should be just below the lip. Boom. That's actually perfect. So 6.9 ounces of water added to that. So we have about 19 ounces of the honey powder, and we have about 19 to 20 ounces of the honey powder, and then 19 to 20 ounces of the warm water. So I'm just gonna stir this up here and make sure that it all dissolves, and then, you know, I'll come back and say hi and we'll figure out what's going on with this. Okay, so that's pretty much dissolved right there. This is, I don't wanna tell you how hot it is, but it's definitely above like 120 degrees Fahrenheit. So, I don't know. I don't know what I'm gonna do with this. At the moment, it kind of looks like just like a regular honey syrup. Really very dark. Very, very dark, and it smells like honey syrup. It's viscous too. Okay, so now we have this sitting just above 100 degrees Fahrenheit, which is just good enough to take a reading and get an accurate reading of this. So right now I'm going to take this, and this is honey for sure. I mean, it's really dark, so I don't know if the mixture of like half and half by weight is going to be what I want to go with, but this is definitely like honey right here. Oh, straight honey. Let's pour without spilling. Oh yeah. Oh yes, look at that pour. Perfect. And just so it starts to rise. Ooh, that is really high in sugars. Whew, very, very high. So yeah, by weight, probably I would say use 2 to 1 water to honey. Because this is sitting right now at 1.17. So that's super viscous. That's actually probably somewhere around where honey would be sitting normally. Maybe a little bit under that, because this stops at 1.17. So we definitely have to add more water to this. I would definitely add 20 more ounces of water to that per 20 ounces of honey powder, but as it sits, let's just get a little taste of that. Oh yeah, definitely. This is really good for what it is. I got 3 pounds of this for $9, and if all I have to do is add 2 to 1 water to honey powder, then I might just end up using honey powder instead of purchasing wet honey, just for myself, you know. But the real test is, will it ferment, and how does the finished product taste? So that's what we're going to do today. I'm going to take the rest of this honey powder, and I'm going to dissolve it in a gallon of water. So let me take this and pour it into my fermenter right here. All right, so that was about a quart of liquid. Let me say I'm gonna add, 50 ounces of water to this, and then we'll add the rest of this honey powder, and we'll take another gravity reading, and we'll see you then. Okay, so it seems like we've gotten the majority of the honey powder and the water to dissolve together. So now comes the important part. What is the gravity of all of this? So this is the remainder of the bag, which was about 28 ounces of honey powder left in this bag, because I think 3 pounds of this was something like 48 ounces of honey powder. So what I'm going to do now is, this actually seems like, let me see if it'll just drop down and float. So it will. So what we got here is we have about the same. So adding 50 ounces of water to this kind of kept it at that same level. It's maybe 10 points of gravity less than it was when we just did the quart. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add cold water to this all the way to the top and see what that does to our gravity. Right there. And let's take that final reading. Drop it. So this is reading 1.13. So I got a little bit more sugars than I wanted to get out of it. And maybe this isn't all mixed up and incorporated yet. So maybe it just needs to be kind of mixed up here so all that water gets evenly distributed. But as it is right now, this is thick. So this is more than 3 pounds of wet honey. This is probably 4 to 5 pounds of wet honey, which for $9, that's a steal. I might have to solely just do honey powder from now on, because that's economical right there, bud. So it's reading at 1.122. So that's not bad, actually, when you fill it all the way up to the gallon line. If I was doing this normally, I would probably let it sit right here at the shoulder, which is kind of where it's sitting at right now, so that's not bad. This will give us about maybe a 15 to 16% alcohol mead, which for traditional is pretty good. So this is actually kind of more of a traditional, going to be more of a traditional style mead. And if I use my 18%, wine yeast on this, it'll go all the way dry. It'll maybe go down to it'll maybe go down to 1.0, which is pretty good since I like my meats to be a little drier. And if it's like slightly sweet, I don't have a problem with that either. But dang, as an experiment goes, this is looking like it's promising right here. I'm really excited for this. I'm going to let this come down to temperature, and then we'll come back to add our yeast, and we'll be done with this one today. Okay, we are just about ready to add our yeast to this must. Let's just take a look at the temperature here. If it's sitting just above 100, I don't really have a problem with adding the yeast in, and yeah, that's probably sitting at like 105. You know, as long as you don't add your yeast at like 115 or above that, you should be fine. This is a, what I'm using today is a Premier Blanc white wine yeast. It's a product of Belgium. It's the Red Star brand. And there's about 2 ounces of yeast left in this. And because this is so high in sugar, I'm gonna use all 2 ounces of that. Usually I would only use about 1 ounce per gallon, but I'm gonna use all 2 ounces of that right in there. And then just stir it up real good. Make sure it gets nice and incorporated and we get some air, oxygen in there. It's very important to make sure that you oxygenate your brew right at the very beginning, because it helps your yeast to get a nice, good foothold and start in. You know, normally I would have hydrated my yeast for this, but, you know, at this point, this is just an experiment. I'm not looking for expediency with, you know, how fast my yeast work. If this takes about 12 hours to 24 hours to get going, that really doesn't bother me. It does not bother me none. Let's talk about the color on this must right here. This is probably the darkest must color I have seen in any of my meads that I've ever brewed. I've made a Boucher before and it was not as dark as this. Especially considering how light the powder was, just how dark of a honey it ends up making. It's really, really interesting. And just from the flavor profile of this, you get kind of like a smoky flavor profile, really sweet, earthiness. So this is going to be an interesting traditional mead, and that's kind of what I'm doing. So I would have done, normally, I would have done a plethora of things to this. I would have added tea, I would have added nutrient, but as it stands, I'm not going to add anything to this. Number one, because there's not much room sitting at the top of this. And number two, I want to just, you know, try this out as a nice traditional mead so that I can see how the honey powder is compared to, say, regular honey that you would buy at the store or that you would buy bulk. So I think I've oxygenated this just enough. Gonna go ahead and put the cap on, and then, you know, it's in the other room, but I'll have to put an airlock in this just to seal this up and to, you know, keep it safe from any bugs or bacteria that might want to get into it. But on the whole, I'm feeling really good about this honey powder. It tastes great. I like the flavor profile on it, and for what it is, it gives you a lot. Like, this is just about 3 pounds of honey powder, but for the sugars that it gave me, it was close to like 4.5-5 pounds for $9. That's really not that bad. I'm going to think really hard about whether I want to use honey powder instead of, you know, regular honey for making products for myself. Because this is honey powder, does it make it mead? I don't know. I will have to see how this, you know, even if it starts fermenting or how it turns out at the end of its fermentation. But as it stands right now, I would say I'm about 75 to 80% of the way there to saying that yes, this will be mead. I would consider it mead, and I would really like to hear from any other brewing channels out there. If you guys happen upon this video, what do you think? Is it okay to use something like honey powder, which is honey, and it's comparable to about 3 pounds of powder to about 4.5-5 pounds of honey? So what do you guys think? Leave a comment down below, and you know, I'll get back to you, and in my update, we'll talk about it. But, you know, I have nothing else to say. I've got nothing else to do. If you like this video, hit that like button and subscribe if you know anybody that might like to learn how to brew or is interested in learning about mead and about, like, what it is, then send my video their way. Other than that, thank you very much, everybody. I'll see you later.